Hey guys, Patrick back with you with another martial arts story. And today we're going to talk about when my fake martial artist friend tried to run his own dojo, so to speak. Now, he didn't have any place to train, so it was operated entirely out of his backyard, but he still liked to call it a dojo. What he would do is he would get people together and train them. Obviously, that's what you do at a gym or at a dojo or whatever, but he would do things a bit differently. So you see, people knew me and they knew who I was and what I did and all that stuff, you know, because I got into a lot of fights and stuff and I was known at the local gyms and stuff like that. And so what he would do is he would essentially attach himself to me to bolster his own credibility. And also, you know, just straight up lie about certain things. Like, they'd be like, oh, you know Patrick? I know Patrick for fighting and whatnot. And then he'd be like, no, I trained Patrick. You know, making it sound like I was kind of like an entire product of him. Like, all of my success can be contributed to his amazing teaching. Even though when I did start learning from him, I sort of faced a regression as a fighter. But, you know, we've been through all that before. But so anyway, he used that, and I didn't find this out until years later, that to trick people into private lessons for money. See, I didn't know that any cash exchanged hands until years later, but he was selling himself, like legitimately making money off of lies and invalid credentials. What did this training consist of, you might wonder? Well, not much. Basically, he would always take these people back to his backyard, and he would be like, all right, maybe we'll do some exercise. And by we, I mean you. I ain't doing nothing. I'm fucking 450 pounds. You think I'm doing shit? So he would make people do, sometimes he would make people do push-ups and sit-ups and jog and basic, you know, body weight exercises, but he would ask them to do ludicrous numbers. And again, these people were not guys who knew their shit. You know, these weren't boxers and wrestlers. These were theater geeks and marching band guys and you know, guys who weren't used to sports of any kind, let alone combat sports. So he'd ask them to do like 500 push-ups, 500 sit-ups, and, you know, obviously they couldn't do it, so he's just like, work on that. I'm not going to give you any tips on it. Just do more. And then, as for technique-wise, I remember all that he would teach them, because he would teach them all the same exact thing. So he would teach them an inward block, an outward block, upward block, low block, all the regular karate stuff, karate punch, karate kicks, stuff like that. Like, very, very basic rudimentary striking. Didn't teach them how to set it up or angles or footwork or anything. No, just here's some blocks, here's some strikes. All right, now we're going to spar. And his justification was to this was the only way to progress in your martial arts training is to spar. Which is largely true. You do need to spar in order to progress as a fighter. But you don't spar day one. You don't even spar month one. You take a good amount of time to let these guys get their basics in, especially if they're people who've never thrown a fucking punch before. And you let them get their basics, you let them settle in their base, and then after they've got a good amount of understanding of what's going on, then you spar. And then that's when shit starts to click. When you can and can't do shit and stuff like that. You don't, okay, here's a punch. Let's fucking fight. And he wouldn't go easy on these guys either. He would fuck these guys up. Like, full force strikes to the face, full force kicks to the body. He did not hold back. And again, he was fucking 400 pounds. So he outweighed these guys by a lot. I'm talking, like, the heaviest guy there was probably 160-ish. And largely the reason he did this was to, for his own vanity, kind of be like, see, look how easily I can destroy you. oh yeah, look how easily you can destroy someone who's never fought before and weighs 300 pounds less than you. Real fucking tough guy. And whenever they complained about, you know, that things seem to be moving too fast, that, you know, they're just getting the shit beat out of him, basically. Whenever they complained about that, he's like, well, did you think fighting was gonna be easy? And no, fighting is not easy. But when all your training consists of is just some fat asshole beating the shit out of you, and you're just paying money for that experience, look somewhere else. This is not a good environment to learn. Because that's what it's supposed to be, learning. You're supposed to learn what you can and can't do and what you should be trying to do in a fight. Not, oh, I'm just going to get the shit beat out of me every day and maybe I'll pick something up. And so this dojo idea of his was very short-lived because of the way that he fucking ran it in the ground. You know, people started to drop out rapid. The most people he had at a time was like 10. And they started to drop out one by one. And he'd just be like, well, then they don't have the heart of a true fighter, unlike the rest of you here. This dojo lasted for about a month before it just collapsed inwards. And nobody new came and took their place. You know, no, the longest time anyone stuck around, like, straight through it was 2 weeks. You know, again, people didn't want to just pay money to get the shit kicked out of them for, let's just say, an hour and a half. I don't know exactly how long these classes ran. But yeah, ultimately, that was how that ended. That's how he ran a school for a month. And again, this was all shit that I didn't find out about until years later when, like, people who used to train at in his backyard would come up to me and be like, oh man, I don't know how you do it, man. You must be so tough to put up with those beatings every day. And I was just like, I don't know what the fuck you're talking about. And, you know, they explained the whole situation to me and I was just flabbergasted. But so yeah, guys, that's just been another story from me. I'm Patrick, and I'll see you next time.